Welcome back. Today I want to show you how to back up the database in MySQL. Before to start, we check a machine where you put the backup, but in this case I want to use the image backup. Okay, it's difference between image backup and directory backup. I use image backup. Okay, donc backup and restore MySQL databases. We use MySQL backup command. Okay. And in this case, the command is we take this. Before to start, I want to check in my databases to show me I test this. We remove these databases, okay? And after we restore, we must find, we imagine we drop many databases and we want to restore it. So before to start, I show my databases, show me this, okay? And here, I launch, I come here. Okay, we use the command with a compress. MySQL backup with compress. Okay. Okay, and here we use this is my directory of a backup. Okay, I use this command. Okay, before to start, I remove all old backup in this directories. After, I launch my command here. Okay, MySQL backup. The default file you put here. This is only the copy of my file. It is here. Okay. Locate my dot CNF. Okay, it this. Okay. CPIP. Ctrl C. Okay. Yes. Okay. So the second command is force. Force means when I want to back up the image, you can rewrite the image, the old image. Okay, so I use force to put if this file exists, okay, he write it again. The Book of Deer, it's my Book of Deer, it's same year. You see? I must press the Book of Deer. And the compress and compress lever. Okay. I had compress and compress lever. By default, you use compress level 6. I put compress level 9. Okay. This I finish. Can put it because it's Linux. Sometimes it's best to have one line with Linux. Okay. Okay. Compress level. I finished my backup. So I take this. I launch my backup. You must to find the backup is completed. Okay, but it told me one warning. Don't worry for a warning. You go only in your file to find a warning. Okay, it say warning. You put the force, he write in the old image of a backup, okay? My image is here, okay? So backup is okay, but before to continue, we must to test this backup. Before to continue, I put another command is admin, okay. We check the version of SQL, the port, okay, it's okay. And the important thing is this. This is similar with with MariaDB, when you put to prepare, okay, validate is the same. Validate, we must check if our backup can be restored without issue. Okay, I take this. This I put it number 2. Okay, number 1, I launch my backup. Okay, this I remove all the directory, and this is number 2. Okay, number 2 is to launch. Validate because the backup is compressed. I must put in compress. Okay. Copy. We check. It told me the backup can be restored. Okay. Put here the message. It's okay. When I finish here, I can test to restore the database I drop. Okay, now I want to drop Sakila. Okay, I drop database Sakila. Database test. test DB. I drop database for my test employer. Because for example, employer, I say use employer. Okay. Show table. A mini table inside. Okay. Now, use MySQL. Drop database. Database employers. Okay. I drop the database. Now, if I say show databases, no Sakila, no. Okay. And we have a backup. We test, we validate, it's okay. But we want to test to restore this database we have damaged or dropped. Or okay, in this case, we drop the database, okay? And we want to restore it. And for that, we use MySQL backup. Okay. Before to restore, it's very important to, okay, we put the validate, say, okay, the backup is complete, okay. In my demo, I create one directory. This directory is to put all file from, because we must to clean here before to restore, very important. Number three is to clean the directory of the var mysqlib, and here. We must to clean this var lib mysql. We must to check in this directory of image. Okay, this directory is clean. Data dir. So before to do that, we stop the service. Okay, we stop the process of mysql. And I create this directory. Control C. I can create here. Okay. I create this. I give write to read and to read. And when I finish, okay, I try to copy. I can copy varlib, okay. I can drop, okay. But for you, it's very important to copy, to move it in this directory, because sometimes when you test, it's not okay. You can put your file and to restart the service. So I take this file, I say remove, okay, Control C. Yes, I go to check here, nothing, okay, I remove it, and I come here, I remove this file, I must to remove a file in this, it's okay, this, I put this in the old repository, two things. My data dir, this is my data dir, I move it here. Yes. again, and I go to check the status of a service. Status. Is down, okay. Server shutdown complete, okay. And I come here, I take my restore command. You see the restore command. We have two words, and compress. And copy back and apply the log. You see, and the log. When I drop here, we find it here. Okay. So here I copy. I launch the command of restore. Same thing. I put in the same line because it's Linux. The command is, I use MySQL backup, default file is my file, backup image, it's here, backup dir, it's here, and in compress and copy, apply log. When we launch this command, we must to find okay, Control C. I can put it here. Exit. Okay, here. I can put it because we start here. I open a little bit big. Okay, we have MySQL backup, default file, home backup, my CNF I copy, okay, it is here, backup image, it's my image of databases, all databases, okay, here, backup dir, it's here, in compress, here, I remove. Space is not a big mistake, but it better be correct. Okay, I finish my restore. It's okay. If error happened, we try to correct. Oh, it told me error. You know why? Because this directory, okay, is not empty. We must only to remove the data here. I say move. I can put mf. Okay. I destroy. To put this directory to be empty. Okay. Boom. And I try again. The directory is okay. I try again. Log. You see another error. You see the varlib exists, it's not empty. You know why? Because when I exit my SQL here, it write information in varlib. You must to put it again. Okay, we take this normal because when you connect. And you put information in MySQL. MySQL go to put information in inside. It's okay. And we test again. Okay. Go. Okay, you finish to restore. Here you see, okay, with tree warning is normal because it's a warning. Don't worry for that. But when we come here, we can check this warning information here. Okay. Information main. A warning is here. He say if you use a different version, don't forget to put this value. InnoDB, okay, this, okay. Don't forget to put this InnoDB log file group 2. Don't forget to put InnoDB log file size this because you must respect the same from your origin configuration. Okay, so you finish, and here we come in here. Don't worry, don't worry. I take my command. I take my command. I put here. Okay. I try to connect in mass. When you finish, before to start, we must put again. These directories var lib, okay, control C, shown à MySQL, okay, control V, okay, this is, I think, the five or the four to do, and the six is systemctl start MySQL services. OK. Before this, shown. Because when we go, yes, okay, we have MySQL here, okay, we finish, we take this, okay, and after we test the status of these services. Status is okay, Q, okay. And after that, we can connect to launch this command. Okay. Control C here. Okay. Something here, clear. Okay. Here, the same. Clear. Okay, and when we launch, it restore the database, and the database will drop Sakila employer. Okay, we can to go to check inside the use employers. Show tables. Okay, we restore our table inside. Okay, so for this reason, we restore the databases and we finish here. How to backup and to restore MySQL databases, and here we use the compress command. Okay, we use MySQL button with compress command. Thanks so much for watching this video, and see you in the next video. Thanks so much. Bye.